Hi there. So I've been thinking about this this course that I'm putting together, called One Rindle at a Time Works, really based on the book and really based on the YouTube channel. And first off, a couple of things have struck me in order to get this right and make it something that I'm proud of. First and foremost, I need to have a focus or a goal, and it needs to be, as best I can, sort of focused on what it was we did when we were just starting out. And really what I need to focus on is, again, it's sort of that building confidence. I apologize for my writing, but it's going to help me kind of stay focused for this presentation. And when I think about confidence, and I kind of flash back to where I was 15 or 16 years ago, it's pretty easy to remember that I didn't have any answers. I didn't know anyone, right? I didn't know the market. I didn't know rents, I didn't know fees, I didn't know what insurance cost. And now stuff that I frankly take for granted, I need to remember I wasn't always certain of. Right, that's first. Second, I need to step back and appreciate what teachers do. Right? Thinking about putting together a course that is impactful and something that you're gonna be proud of is not easy, right? I released that free course on Teachable called One Rindle at a Time Works. It had about 90 minutes of content, and that took weeks to put together. I can't imagine what this one is going to take, given that I've spent 48 hours and I don't even have an outline yet. So shout out to all the teachers out there, and for the people that have put together courses and helped people, kudos. It's harder than people think. But back to this idea of confidence. What I've come to, and I want to share with you and just see if you agree, there's two things that I look at now that really allowed us to take substantial steps forward. And the first one is, and they're really both foundational elements, is, it's really understanding an area or a type, right? It's impossible in this business in the beginning to look at all things and go, hey, I want to go after apartments, or I want to go after affordable housing, or I want to do condominiums, or I want to do notes, or I want to do this, or I want to do that. So one of the things I'm going to have to get right is narrow people's focus, right? For me, that meant narrowing down to bread and butter houses. That meant narrowing down even further into an area. So I need to figure out how to communicate that. And likely try to do several different ways. Do PowerPoints, do videos, do whiteboards, all of that. That's one thing. And I need to give work that somebody anywhere across the world can go do in their area, right? Maybe it's somebody in the Bay Area that's looking at Detroit. Maybe it's someone in New York that's looking at Texas. Maybe it's someone in Europe that's looking at Florida. I don't know who's gonna watch this. So this is a hard riddle to crack. And then, the other thing is how to compare deals. Right? This is something that's not as easy as it sounds, right? It's easy now for me because I have my method, right? I have the thing I do. But when you're starting out and you look at cap rates and IRRs and cash on cash and cash flow and all these vocabulary words and all these quote unquote experts, no, I don't think they're doing it on purpose to confuse you, but I was confused, right? I had to find something that worked for me. So I'm going to share with you, and I've shared another video that's kind of a snapshot of what I do, but I'm going to go in detail at what I do, why I do it. It's admittedly simple, but it works for me, and I still use it today, right? The thing that I'll share, I still use today, right? I basically take all the cash I put down, and then I try to calculate the expected cash flow for a year after it's operational. And then that produces what I call yield, right? I don't care about mortgage pay down. I don't care about discount to purchase. I don't care about any of those things. I want to know how much cash I'm taking out of my bank account and how much is coming in my bank account. Everything else is irrelevant. Yes, I know appreciation happens. Yes, I know mortgage pay down happens. Yes, I know you have depreciation. Yes, I know all that stuff. But at least in my world, I live on the cash that's in my bank account. So I want to know how much I take out and how much I put in. So that's the thing for me. So I have to get these two things right. But that's not it. I then have to talk about how these relate, right? Because when you have your comparison and you have your number, right,
Then you get to compare areas, and then you get to, you know, bring down. And
then you get to figure out that list price is just a number, and how do you control cash, and how do you do owner financing and reduce the down payment? There's lots of things. So this has proven to be a very hard riddle for me to figure out. I'm going to need certainly another couple of days to kind of put together an outline that's going to make sense before I really can start creating videos. But if you have ideas or thoughts, let me know. I'd love to hear from you. Lots of people watch this. And then the other thing that's clear to me is after I get this right, these are the big rocks for course one. Don't be confused. I'm going to spend a lot of time on understanding, helping people understand their area and get comfortable. I'm going to give you a lot of time understanding the numbers and how to compare deals. Because what I have to do for you is you have to understand what a bad deal is, what an average deal is, what a good deal is, and what a great deal is. Today, too many people, a deal is a deal, right? They're all equal. And the last thing you could do after being through my course is think that all deals are equal. They're not. You should be able to rank all the property opportunities you have top to bottom, right? The bottom is obviously the bad deals. Maybe the middle swag or the average deals. Maybe the, you know, deal 3 through 6 are good deals, but it's deal 1 and 2 that are great deals. And I don't think anybody really focuses on that. So that's what I'm going to focus on, is helping you understand your area, understand how to do deals, and then confidently rate them. If I can do this for you inside a course, I think we win. But I'm going to do more, because once you do this and you're like me and you're going back to year one, then it's about how to find a property manager, right? How to interview them. Right? I've already shared painfully in the book and through videos that we went through 5 property managers in 5 years. Horrible experience. Right? I had one for as little as 90 days. And so we'll talk about that. Then we'll talk about buying in your own backyard or turnkey models. And then we'll add a lot of bonus videos. I know one I'm seeking thoughts on now is quotes from other successful investors. But again, this is going to be, this is not going to be released until it's something I'm proud of. But I'm here to tell you that the big rocks are going to be understanding your area and being confident, and then how to calculate compare deals. Again, this is my story and what we did, but that's what this is going to be about. And then we'll do all the extra things, property management, how to run a business, all of those things. But I believe if we can get this right together, that you're going to be more confident. And that's really my goal of this first course. Have a great day.